You need to lift your voice a bit.
I'm Ben Brett, and this is my phone control panel project. My project came about because we have a sump pump which is controlled by a small panel located near the pump. However, the building was in flooded, completely ruining our panel. This then had to find another way of controlling the panel, the pump. And a couple of options. One was to simply fit a on-off switch to the incoming power to the pump. Another was to attempt to build the control panel into an existing section of a larger panel. However, it would have been very difficult to be right at the very top and making any maintenance very difficult to achieve. So this led me to the third option, which was to build an entirely new panel to control the pump using the same specifications as the previous panel.
Very good.
Project was compressed into a much smaller space of time. In order to do this, I made available additional hours for manufacturing, allowing it to be manufactured faster by just sort of doing overtime to get it completed. Issues in production as well, especially when producing the holes needed for the main isolation switch. We didn't have any cutters capable of drilling stainless steel at that size, so new cutters had to be ordered, which did a slight delay on completing that particular section. However, I worked on other sections whilst waiting for the parts to arrive. It's now been mounted and signed off by our electrical engineer at Thames Water. It's spent the day in the electrical workshop being tested on the bench. And there's a short video of that in a minute. It's now in place and working. However, we discovered a new problem because we attempted to use the existing probe and cabling. The probe has deteriorated over time, so that will now have to be replaced.
Skip the video.
Yeah. It's good.
Very good. Just a couple of questions though. Can you maybe describe to us what's the wiring and what went on within the box? Because you didn't have a picture of the panel open or the wiring behind it, that's all. Or maybe I missed one. Oh, right, yes. All right.
Sorry.
All right, yes, yeah, go on, yeah. Just tell us a bit more about how you did that.
It's just wired with a incoming, two-phase incoming supply, three-phase incoming supply, which will go in there. It hasn't been completed at this stage because this was whilst it was still on test bench. Goes through a contactor and overload for the pump here, out of the pump, the rest of it. Is purely for the control system. The control system is simply takes the neutral and one phase, so it's 110 volts. One extra that I might would add if I had more time would have been added a transformer to drop that to 24 volts, make it safer.
That's good. Thank you very much.